See, my name is Ravi Kumar. So first problems on solids, that is square prism. So square prism 35mm sides of base and 65mm axis length, rest on HP and one of its edge. See, 35mm square I have constructed already. Okay, I already constructed, so it is a base. Clear? We show the 35mm dimension. See, they clearly mention one of its edge. It means the edge is in towards your right hand side. Okay, so do the naming. A1, BB1, CC1, DD1. Okay, and draw very thin projection line, because that is not visible. That's why we have to draw thin projection line. So that is OO1. Okay, so next they given 65mm height. So take 65mm axis height. Okay, so this I have already taken 65mm. Axis height, okay, 65mm axis height. Okay, see, this is a bottom face and this is a top face. As you're looking from here, A1 is visible, D1 is invisible. So A1 dash, D1 dash, A dash, D dash, O1 dash, O dash, B1 dash, C1 dash, B dash, and C dash. So this is the first position. Okay, so what is the next position? Okay, see here, and read the second. Draw the projection of prism when axis of prism is inclined to both HP and VP. I already told in the previous video, if the axis of the prism is inclined both HP and VP, so that is a locus problem. If the word appear present, it is a without locus problem. So now, the axis of the prism is inclined to both HP and VP, so it is a locus problem. Okay, so we'll construct HP. Second position is what? Is inclined to HP at 45 degree. Okay, see, you can't incline this axis to a 45 degree directly. Okay, because of that, we'll finding out base angle. Okay, how to find out base angle? See, base angle is equal to 90 minus theta. So they given 45 degree, so we'll get 45. Base angle is also 45 degree. Okay, first we'll take a base angle, then we'll construct. Okay, base angle will always take towards our left hand side. Please be careful. Base angle we have to take towards our left hand side. Okay, so how to take? See here. I'll take, this is a point. Okay, so from this point, you take 45 degree towards your left hand side. We always, you know, in the planes we'll take what we'll take, a right hand side. But here base angle you have to take towards your left hand side. Okay, please be careful. We have to take towards left hand side. Okay, see. Now, measure it and draw very thin line. Okay, na? Okay, so after that, measure the distance of base. So this is always 35mm only. Okay, so measure it. Okay, now measure it. So from here we cut an arc. Okay, and similar way from here to axis, measure it and cut an arc. Okay, now what is the next step? What is the next step we have to follow? Okay, that is a very important one. So use roller scale. Use roller scale to avoid confusion. Okay, so what is a confusion? See, you have to take 90 degree. Okay, now how to take 90 degree? So very important. So first take one, you take any one line 90 degree, then automatically you can take other two lines as well. See, from one line you take 90 degree. Okay, na? So now it is a 90 degree line. I'll draw 90 degree line. Okay, na? So push. Clear. Next. Over. So very simple, very easy to take 90 degree. So now you take 6.5. Okay, now so 1 to 6.5, this is the 6.5. Next, similarly draw, take 6.5. Okay, similarly draw, then take 6.5. Over. Very simple, right? Okay. So now draw thick line. Okay, because all are visible, so draw thick line. Okay, now see, I'll check it out whether it is, I'm sorry, 6.5, right? So from here, okay, so this is a dotted line. Okay, so this line is not there, I'm sorry. I can't able to edit because I'm using pen. So now extend this line up to a XY line. So show this angle is a 45 degree. Okay, now do the naming. So this is A1 dash, D1 dash, A dash, D dash, O1 dash, O dash, and this is B1 dash and C1 dash. This is B dash and C dash. Okay, what is the next step? So now draw line, downward line. See, don't draw unnecessary extra lines up to where you want, you just draw. Okay, see, this is a D point, right? D and C. So up to here I want, and I will draw up to there only. Okay, see. What is this? A1 is there. So here it is A1. Here it is D1. Okay, similarly, next. From here to here. So what is this line? This is a B1 and this is a C1. Okay, why I'm not mentioning C dash? Because it's a top view, not a front view. Okay, so here also. Okay, now up to where you want, you just draw up. Don't draw extra line and it's a killing of the time, okay, in exam. See, this is a D and this is B and this one is C. Next is what? O. For O you have to draw. This is O1 and this one is O. Okay, so now it's a very very tricky job. Now you have to mention which one is a visible and which one is an invisible line edges. Okay, see, if you're looking from top of an object, now tell me which one is an invisible and which one is a visible. See, this is a 3D object. If you're looking from top of an object, this edge is invisible, right? Okay, so this edge you have to mention it as an invisible edges. Okay, means A dash and D. One dash is invisible, so you have to mention it is an invisible line. Okay, so very very important this is. Okay, now this is an invisible line. So rest of all the edges are visible line. So you just join with the help of visible line. Join with the help of visible line. Visible line, clear? So this is also visible. Okay, so only this A dash, A1 and D1 is invisible. Okay, and this is the axis. We just show the axis. Okay, so this is the second position. You understood, right? How to write the visible and invisible? If you're looking from bottom of an object, this point is invisible point. That's why I'm drawing it with the help of invisible line. Okay, so this is a second position. So now you just mention this dimension, find out this dimension. Okay, so this dimension is around 4.9. okay, so 49 mm. So now tell me which one is the apparent and which one is the true length. So this is an apparent length and this is a true length. Understood? This is the apparent and this is a true length. We'll see how to construct this final position. So final position, they given VP is 30 degree. Okay. So I'll leave 1-2 line. So then I'll leave 1-2 line. So VP is 30 degree. Okay. So 30 degree. Okay na? So next. And from here I'll take 30 degree line. Okay na? So this is a 30 degree line. Okay, what is the next step? You have to find out beta angle. So that is one of the very important, almost all the students are making a mistake here. Okay, so first you take true length. Okay, true length you have to take. This is a true length. Okay, you have to take true length. Okay na? Select any one point. Any one point, I will select here and I will cut an arc. Understood? I will select this point, okay, and I will cut an arc. Okay, now true length I took now. After that, I will draw locust line. After that, I will draw locust line. Okay, after that, I will draw locust line. Next, I will take apparent length. This is apparent length. I'll take apparent length. From the same center line, you have to draw one more curve. Okay, you have to draw one more curve. That is the apparent length curve. Okay, so it is intersecting the locus line. See, here it is intersecting. You join from here to here, then extend it to x finite. Okay, now find out the angle. So what is the angle here? It is around 45 degree. Okay. So now it is around 42. You are getting 42, 41 degree. Okay. So beta will be 41 degree. Okay now. So now is very important step. You have to replace this box here. Okay. So this box here means it is there and you have to replace like this. Okay now. If you replace like this, you will get bottom, you know, top position will be in the bottom and top will be the bottom will be in the up. Okay, see, it is like this and you have to replace like this. Understood? So now how to replace? So what are the points you will be having? Now you will be having O1 and you will be having O. Okay, so from here you take 90 degree. From here you take 90 degree line. I'll tell you why. From here you take 90 degree. Okay. I'll take 90 degree. Not much. Okay. Very simple. Okay na? And why it is required? See, I have to find out from O1 to this midpoint, or you find out O1 to this point. Okay, which one is easy? So better O1 to this point. Okay, or you can take it as O1 to this midpoint, O2 this midpoint. Okay, so now whatever I have taken O1 90 degree line and O 90 degree line, so I will measure from O to C, you know, O to this point, O to this point. So how much is the distance? I will measure it. Okay, or else you can use a compass, it's better, easy to construct. Easy to construct, see. From O1 to this point is common, okay, it's common in all the directions. So cut, from here also, cut, and then this side, cut, and then this side also cut. Over. So next, similar way, draw one box. Okay, draw one box. From here also, I draw box. Okay, you got a box. Now you have to identify all the points. Okay, so from this point to this point you have to identify the distance. Okay, you just extend it little bit, extend this little bit like this. Okay, extend this little bit, and then now see, now very easy to construct. You can just identify, you know, observe clearly. See, now if you measure from ear to ear, so it is equal from ear to ear, and then similarly if it is equal from ear to ear, it is equal from ear to ear. So now easy to cut. 1, 2, next from ear 3, next from ear 4. Now draw box, one more box. 1 and this is 2. Okay, what is the point? So this point is A, this point is D, and this point is C, and this point is B. Okay, here B1 and C1, this is top. Now we have to identify D1 and C1. Okay, so again very simple. Again it is very simple. So from here to here, similarly from this line to same distance. Okay, you can cut from here to here, and from here to here, again from here to here, again from ear to ear. That's it. Okay, so easy. Just draw thin line. Okay, I'll draw thick line here. Okay, now what is this point D1, and what is this point A1 and C, and this one is P. Okay, so now draw with a visible line. I'll draw with a. Okay, see, now you can see this. Okay, now I have, you know, place this thing here, and I have to draw, I have to extend the line upward. Okay, simple man, very simple. Okay, so from where is this B1 point, where is B1 and here. Okay, you need not to draw any extra line, so up to B1 only. Okay, B1 here, and you join this. See, whatever I am following, you follow this method, it's easy only. If you are doing something extra, so it is a bit difficult to complete. So this is C dash, and next A1. A1 is on XY line. Next is D1 dash. Next B, B dash, next C dash. D dash, next is O. One dash, next this one is O. O dash. Okay, here you have to follow a very simple method. First you have to join all the outer edges. Outer edges is what? D1 to D, D to C, C to B, then B to B1, then B to A1, then D1. These are the outer edges. So you join all the outer edges with visible line. finished. Okay, next, if you're looking from bottom of an object, this complete is visible, right? What is this? This is the top face. Okay, so top face is visible. So top face is what? A, D, C, B. So now join with a visible line. Okay. Join with a visible line. Okay, which one is invisible? C dash is invisible. Okay, so line joining between invisible point to visible point is with the help of invisible line. Okay, so C to C, invisible. Okay, next, and C to B is also invisible. Okay, now, and before that, you just check it out, which one is invisible? Yeah, C to C is invisible. Okay. Next, this is invisible. Rest one is visible one. Join with a visible line. Next is O to O. Join with the axis. Okay, this completes the problem, and you have to mention here beta is equal to 41 degree. Okay, thank you.